This is going to be a weird one, partially because Hugo doesn't really lend itself to a simple analysis. It's a very good film by one of our greatest filmmakers, but it's not a great one, and it ultimately doesn't really work for a fairly specific yet complicated reason, but also because that very specific complicated reason involves a massive spoiler that comes in the very middle of the film, which kind of limits how much I can say about, well, anything. So here's the deal. When it gets to be time, I'm putting up the spoiler warning, but overall, if you're really interested in seeing Hugo and or really sensitive about spoilers, you should probably just go see Hugo and then watch the rest of the review. Okay? Okay. So, Hugo is an adaptation of The Invention of Hugo Cabret by Brian Selznick. The title character is an orphan living secretly within the labyrinthine clock systems of a railway station in 1930s Paris, France, trying to stay one step ahead of a nosy station inspector played by Sacha Baron Cohen while covertly swapping various mechanical parts from an elderly toy shop owner played by Ben Kingsley. The opening sequence establishing all this stands as one of the all-time virtuoso moments of Scorsese's career, and believe the hype, this could easily be the best use of modern-day 3D ever. Hugo seeks the mechanical parts for his obsessive quest to restore a mysterious turn-of-the-century clockwork robot his father had been working on when he died in a freak accident. During his quest, which takes up roughly the first half of the movie, he gets to know the enigmatic toy shop guy and makes a friend of his adopted goddaughter played by Chloe Moritz. Together, they discover the origins of Hugo's robot, which only leads to an even bigger mystery with much more personal stakes. And here's where the spoiler warning has to come in. Seriously, not kidding. The whole movie totally changes genre, focus, tone, and story after this in a way that for a change was not given away in the trailers. So this is your last chance to turn back if you still haven't seen it. In 5, 4, 3, 2... Okay, so it turns out Cranky Grandpa, the toy shop owner, is the creator of the robot, and he's been hiding a secret identity. He's Georges Méliès, a real historical figure. And Hugo, as it turns out, is not really a children's fantasy movie, but rather a heavily fictionalized child's point of view version of how Georges Méliès really was discovered working anonymously in a Paris toy booth. See, in real life, Méliès was one of those guys who pretty much invented the movies back at the turn of the century. He was arguably the first great visionary of the medium, making the first science fiction and fantasy films, and in the process, inventing special effects and, well, movie magic. Unfortunately, after post-World War I cynicism kinda killed off interest in the impressionistic and fanciful films he specialized in and sundry other sordid screwovers, he wound up destitute, selling his film prints to recyclers for money and retreating into a depression, only to be rediscovered later in life. So, there's our big thematic transition. Having fulfilled the childhood task of repairing the robot, Hugo must now graduate to the more grown-up task of repairing the person. This is a really good twist. It's unexpected, it takes the movie in really interesting direction, and it gives Scorsese a chance to delve into some of his big fixations, recreating Méliès' famous studio and practical effects techniques, and playing film history professor to an audience that could use the education. But it's also why the film doesn't totally work. See, the twist neatly divides the film into two distinct halves. The first half being a pretty well-made version of what seems like yet another Dickensian magical orphan pastiche, while the second becomes a loving biopic of Méliès and a vehicle for Scorsese to make an impassioned plea for the preservation and study of classic films. The problem is, while Scorsese is clearly interested in proving that he too can do fanciful Spielberg-style kiddie adventure stuff, in the first half, it's really obvious that the chance to hero worship the elder gods of silent movies in the second half is way more up his alley. Once the Méliès segment starts, you can just sense the reluctance every time the film has to cut back and pretend it's still deeply invested in little Hugo, and it doesn't help matters that his story feels kinda wrapped up by then. He figured out the robot, he's made a friend, even Baron Cohen's bad guy has largely completed his own character arc and isn't all that threatening or villainous anymore. And then the last straw is a depressingly contrived finale, where the otherwise intelligent Hugo decides to reveal information in the most risky and complicated way possible just to put himself in last-minute danger so the film can have tension in the third act, and just for good measure, the bad guy briefly turns bad again just in time, but only for a little while. Hey. Despite the frustratingly schizophrenic nature of the second half, Hugo is still a really good movie, and I do recommend it. I just feel like it should have been a bit better, or at least more cohesive overall. See you next time.